Hi, my name is Sonia and I'm from Barcelona. Before anything else, I want to say sorry because my English is not too good. Here you have subtitles, so please follow them. Well, I come from the world of SEO, but a couple of years ago, I got really interested in artificial intelligence, automatizations, and especially A4 calls. I truly believe in its potential and all the amazing possibilities it offers. In this video, I want to share what I learned from Neil, the CEO of Cloudonix, about how to connect Vapi with virtual numbers for my country. In this case, we'll use numbers from the company Telnyx. Let's begin.
First of all, let me know how it works. I have this model, Cloudonix, on Make. And let's run the scenario, run this model only. Okay.
Hello. Hello, Sonia. Can I tell you a joke? Why don't scientists trust atoms? Because they make up everything.
Wow, it's interesting. Thank you. Well, it's my assistant. Perfect. And then it's all. And the other way is for inbound calls. For this, I can phone her another time. Well, calling to my assistant just now. Okay. Hello?
Hello, Sonia. Can I tell you a joke? Why don't scientists trust atoms? Because they make up everything.
Okay. Thank you. Bye. Okay, she's joking just now, my assistant. And now let's take a closer look at how to implement it. I'm here in Telnyx, and first of all, I bought a number from my city. Okay. Here you can see all availables. There's a lot of phones from Spain. I already have my phone number, is right here, and then the next thing we're going to do is set up the SIP trunking. For this, we can create it in this button, create SIP connection, and we begin by giving it a name, like for example, test, and then the type. It will be FQDN. Now we create it and perfect. Here in this step, we must add the FQDN. In this part, we must to put the domain from Cloudonix, border.cloudonix.io, then save. Okay. And then we scroll, and then this part, primary, FQDN, will be the last one. Perfect. This is for this part. Here, before in inbound call routines, we can put our SIP subdomain, maybe test subdomain, like this. It's okay. And per calls authentication. This will be with method IP addresses. And here we put the IP from Cloudonix. The number is 18219128166. Okay, perfect, save. And in this part, IP authentication method, we need to choose a prefix with phone numbers. It will be easy to remember because later we use in Cloudonix to authenticate the calls. For example, for me, it will be okay, 2578. Okay, next. Here, in configuration, it's all okay, but it's important not to mark this part. Okay, perfect. Now let's configure the internet calls in details. Zip region, this is important. It's inside of Europe, okay? And this part, it's okay. This will be not marked. And here, the codex, the only important is the first one, G722. The only one, the others could be this market. Okay, next. Here, in outbound calls, we need to make the localization. Okay, perfect. And here, outbound voice profiles, we need to configure one, and after it will appear here. Okay, I put in default, by the way, by after that, we will here to configure it, outbound voice profile. Okay, and then next. And this is the last step. We have here our telephone number, and the only, the final step is to assign this number to a SIP trunking. Okay, then continue. In outbound voice profiles, we can create one by the name, I don't know, Sonia. And after this, we're going to select the country another time. Okay. And next. This is okay. All it's okay. Perfect. We just have the connection and application created in this number. And now the final step, we go to Cloudonix. Sign in here and get a trial. Okay, then this is our dashboard, and we go to the container applications. Here we create an application in this container, connect to Marta, for connecting to our assistants. When we have the container done, we can go to the other settings, go to the call, and here all begins. Okay, in the first step, we go to applications. Here we can find plus. Okay, then a name of application. And here we can select container application resource. Here will be our connector and the block. Okay, perfect. Then create. Perfect, it's okay. But that's one thing that we must do, it's this, DNID number. Just here we put something like this, and we have to mark asterisk. Oh, here. Okay, perfect. And this is one, and it's recommendable to put the other one. Okay, this is my mistake, because I have just created here is this the other I will delete it, and then this is mine answer calls Vapi connector, we'll see it inside, and there's we have these two types with asterisk both, and then connect my application with the entry block. Okay, perfect. Then we'll see inbound and outbound trunks in Cloudonix. Okay, first, inbound trunks. Okay, in our inbound trunk, we need to put the address of the SIP, the Telnyx. Then is zip.telnyx.com. And here in prefix is the same that we set early in Telnyx configuration. I think so. Okay, create. And then the same thing with outbound trunks. We create one with one name and the SIP address from Telnyx and the prefix that we make before. Okay. It's okay. Then create. And that's all. Now we have working Vapi with Telnyx, with the Cloudonix Brights. And now the only thing left is to upload the phone to Vapi. Let's do it. This is my Vapi account, and here I don't have any phones I need make for this. Here I want to create my credential ID for after upload my phone to Vapi. Okay, the first one, oh, the trigger, sorry. Here, oops. Okay, perfect. Here in the first endpoint with credential, I will authorization via my API key. And here I want to ask Vapi, which is my credential ID. And then with the outbound of this connection, I will go to the next step to add the phone. For this, I need this endpoint, phone number, my authorization via my API key. And here I put the provider is not Twilio, it's not Ponage, it's another one. And the name of my connection, this is not important, you can put here anything else. My number, my assistant ID, this is not, it's not mandatory, but once I set it up, it directly routes to my assistant. And then the credential ID, this is mandatory, and I put the previous date. Well, let's test it. Okay, runs once, and we can see how all it's 201. It's okay. ID credential is created, phone is update, and we will check it with Vapi. If we go to phone numbers, then it's okay. Here it's our phone number. Perfect. It's ready to make calls. I hope this helps, and thank you for the passion for my English. Bye bye.